Good evening, students. Today I will continue with the next part of the motion in 1D. So in the previous lecture I have already completed what is distance, displacement, the difference between distance and displacement. Later on I have completed velocity, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, speed, difference between speed and velocity, all these things. Today I will discuss some unique problem related to this velocity and distance and all these parameters, and later on I will continue with the acceleration part. Okay, so let us continue. So first of all, that what I have said in the previous video, that is, what is distance and what is displacement. Distance is the path, that is, distance is the path which is covered by a moving body with respect to time, right? And what is displacement? Displacement is the smallest distance from initial to final position. And distance is the scalar quantity and displacement is vector quantity, right? So how I can implement this thing for a numerical part? Let's see. Suppose this is the point A, this is point B, and this is point C. A is my starting point, B is my ending point, right? So suppose this distance is 10 centimeter and this is suppose 5 centimeter. Now my question is, what will be the distance and displacement for this? Okay, so what is the distance? For the distance part, basically, so for the distance part, what is the distance? Distance is the path covered by the particle, right? So from here it will comes to here, it is the initial, it is the final. So the if I calculate the distance, then it will be 10 plus 5 centimeter, that is 15 centimeter, right? Now if I want to calculate the displacement, then what will be the case? For the displacement, the smallest distance, or the the smallest distance from initial to final position, right? So this is the AB, nothing but this AB is nothing but my displacement. So how we can calculate this displacement? That is applying the Pythagoras theorem, that is AC square plus CB square. So for this part, for AC square, that is 10 square, that is 100, and BC square, that is 25. So root over of 125, so it will be 5 root 5 centimeter. So this will be the answer for this figure. The displacement will be 5 root 5 centimeter and the distance will be 15 centimeter. Let us continue with another figure. So a particle is moving through the circular path. A is the initial position, and after a rotation it comes to it, to the A again, right? So what will be the displacement and distance? So the distance is this path, that is, it is a circle. So the perimeter of this circle, that is 2 pi r. So the distance will be 2 into pi is 22 by 7, r is 7. 7, 7 cancel out. So the answer will be 44 centimeter, right? And what will be the displacement? As the initial position and final position is same, so the displacement will be 0, right? for the another figure. So the final position is F, initial position is A. So 2 centimeter okay. So what will be the distance and displacement? So the distance will be basically AB plus BC, CD plus DE plus EF. So the distance AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EF. So it becomes 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is 7 centimeter. What will be the displacement? Displacement will be this. Sorry. So the displacement will be this. So how we can calculate this part? So basically this part, if I draw this, it becomes a right angle triangle. So this is 2, this part is 1 basically, and again this part is 1. So total this part becomes 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. And for this, this is 2 and this is 1. So this part is also 3. So AF will be basically, applying the Pythagoras theorem, root over of 3 square plus 3 square, that is 9, plus 9 root over 18. So 3 root 2. So this will be the displacement. Okay. So like this, you can this type of numericals you can face for this part. Hopefully it is clear to all. Now I am going for the acceleration part. So what is acceleration? Acceleration is basically the rate of change in increase in velocity with respect to time is called the acceleration. And what is retardation? Retardation is just opposite of this acceleration part, that is rate of decrease of velocity with respect to time is called the retardation. Okay. So in the next part, I will continue with the acceleration and retardation part in more precise way. Okay, thank you.